There has been an understandable fear in the last 6 to 8 weeks because we have known so little about what has come upon us with the COVID crisis. But as a result, we shut down all screening mammograms and women are not getting screening. And we know that with the implementation of screening mammography, we've decreased the risk of death secondary to breast cancer by 40%. So throughout this process, my concerns have been getting back to screening for women so that we don't see an increase in death secondary to breast cancer, but also so that we don't see an increase in locally advanced breast cancers, because we have been so successful at de-escalating the amount of treatment women need, but that's been coupled intimately with patients having their diagnosis so much earlier. Cancer doesn't really stop for a pandemic, and it has equal life-threatening outcomes if we don't address it early. Fortunately, we have implemented some very strict policies and procedures that we're following at all of our cancer centers because we want patients to be safe. Now is an appropriate time to begin resuming those screening mammograms. We have strict adherence to all of the providers, whether that be somebody that's rooming you, checking you in, all the way up to the physicians that are taking care of you, wearing masks, as well as the eye protection. We then continue to take that to that next phase of their journey while at the cancer center with how we have reestablished patient visits, spreading them out throughout the course of the day, extending hours even, which includes our screening mammography hours to nights and weekends to be able to adhere to very important social distancing guidelines. By receiving or getting your routine screening mammograms, that allows us to identify breast cancers at much earlier stages. That has played a significant part in improving patient survival. So across the board, it really actually starts with the ground roots of getting screening mammography.